Hey guys, welcome to another episode of What's Your Take? Let's go look at today's topic.
Take?
Yeah.
I didn't take anything from the building. No. They break all.
Flamboyant weddings. Who doesn't want a beautiful wedding? And they say beautiful things are expensive. I mean, take a look at today's. Wouldn't you want your reception to be here? I mean, dancing in between these beautiful things. Ah, God. And it comes to the cost. You can't have some sloppy wedding. How many times do you want to have a wedding? Once, right? So go all out. For me, I even want to have a good time.
Hey, shut up there. What do you know?
Guys, beautiful things are expensive. It is what you want to get married once in your life, right? Or you want to get married twice. So it's once. It's a one-time big investment that's going to pay off. Your kids are going to see pictures. Your grandchildren are going to see pictures. Make it worth their while. Don't do anything shabby. Why are you in a rush? Take your time. Order that most expensive flower bouquet. The most expensive dress. Handcrafted. Oh my God. Make that wedding the top of the town. Make your wedding trendy. That's what we are going for. Don't do anything simple. If you don't have money, don't get married. Wait. That's my take. Let's go look at other people's take.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kwame. Flamboyant wedding expenses. As you can see, I'm not married, but then I have to save my mind. See, if you have the money, do it. If you have the means and the money, just do it. Let it feel like it. Please, so I said what? If you have the money and if you have the means, please, if you don't have it, if you can't afford it, just do your normal thing. Get some meat pie and coke or whatever. Get some canopy, if it's some one room challenge, just get it and move according to your budget. Don't stress. If you have the means, if you're earning like 50,000 a month, getting money like 50,000 a month, you can afford a challenge. Let him do that. That's all. So that's my thing.
Flamboyant wedding expenses. Should we go all out? Or it's not very important? Well, I think this question does not have a right answer. Every answer is right. Because this is where the cut your coat according to your size comes in play. You don't know my pocket, and I don't know your pocket. I can decide to make it big because I have much to spend. And you can decide to make it small because you know you have little to spend. So, for this question and my answer, I would say every answer is right. Cut your coat according to your size. It can be big, it can be small. So that's my take.
It's definitely okay to have a flamboyant wedding if you want a flamboyant wedding, or just spend ridiculous amounts of money on an event. If you have the money, there's definitely nothing wrong with that, because you have the money. It only stops making sense when you know you're tied for money, but then you still want, you know, to go all out, to impress it on people, even yourself. It just doesn't make any sense, because at the end of the day, it is just one event, and then you have the rest of your life to think about. And I know, okay, money comes and it goes, but that doesn't mean you have to be reckless about it. And it is reckless. It is reckless. I know I'm offending some people, but it is reckless. It's, that's my take.
So my thoughts on flamboyant wedding expenses. Flamboyant weddings or noticeable weddings to me are expensive and stressful. Yeah. So personally, I prefer traditional weddings where I get to wear my kente gown, and it's between the two families and relatives and few friends, which I think is simple and really affordable. But maybe after that, and we think we want to still have some fun, then I can just get a white gown and wear and take my pictures. Yeah. So I don't really like flamboyant weddings, but then I'm not against people who are interested in such weddings. It's their choice. We all have our choices. Yeah. So if you have the money, you can afford, you are ready to undertake all this stress, then it's cool. Yeah. So, but for me, I like traditional weddings, simple weddings. Yeah, that's my take.
The thing is that I have double opinion on this issue. Sometimes I see big weddings and I go, oh, I want a big wedding. Sometimes I see simple weddings and I go, oh, I want something as simple as this. If you have the money and you want to go all out, I see no reason why you shouldn't. The problem is with those who have nothing and they go and borrow and end up in debt, end up knees deep in debt. That's not the way to go. But if you have the money and you think, oh, I can do it, I want to invite big people, I want to invite my friends, I want to give souvenirs, I want to give my wedding souvenirs, I want it to be cars, to be cars, to be cars.
They said they are trammy.
I want it to be house, which is not feasible, by the way. Yeah, so that's my take on this issue.
People's take on having a flamboyant wedding. What's your take? Let us know in the comment section. And don't be shy. I mean, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. Let the whole world see. We'll see each other next time. Bye for now.